All right, we're right here with Hector Vazquez, the event coordinator and owner of Sweat Boxing Gym, event coordinator of Mikey Garcia Promotions. Hector, once again, I know we talk every single day about the promotions that are going to take place when?
November 20th, 2020 at Southern Junction Nightclub in Irving, Texas.
You see, I just had to remind you about it. I know you know all about it. Look, a lot of people have not seen, and I personally see it every single day, every time you post it, you talk about it, the little things you do for an event to come up. Tell me one of the hardest things that's presented itself for this promotion that is coming up, because there's been a lot of setbacks for this event that is going to take place in less than a week.
I mean, obviously, I think the COVID rules and restrictions, it has been an insane task to deal with, especially with there not being a blueprint when it came to boxing with the public, with the fighters. So we literally had to, from the ground up, create our own bubble, our own platform. And luckily, you know, doing the research from the NBA, the NFL, the NHL, you know, I got things, a little bit things from all three major sports, combine them and make it relevant to the boxing world and how, you know, it works. And, you know, that's the rules and protocols we're following right now.
Now, tell me a little bit more about this bubble. How's this going to take place? A lot of people don't know.
It's going to be a nightmare. No, you know, obviously, the Texas State Department requires for all fighter coaches and people involved directly with the fighters to do a COVID test, but it's a PCR COVID test. What that means is it's a special test that they has to go straight to the lab. So it can't be a rapid antigen test where you get the results in 30 minutes. It takes, the fastest is 48 hours. It can be from, you know, 2 to 4 days, depending on how intense, you know, COVID cases are. So therefore, we have to create a bubble for that time frame of window. So we got, you know, our test will be on Wednesday, and we get the results the day of the fight on Friday. So literally, we do the COVID test on Wednesday afternoon, then go straight to the hotel, which they lock down a whole wing of the hotel, which is our official bubble. We have a whole entire floor where all the fighters will be with their coaches, you know, supervised, and have security on site where they cannot leave. They can't go to the store, they can't go get food or whatever. Like, everything has to be handmade there and has to be dropped off to their room without nobody touching somebody else. You know, I can't even allow housekeeping to come in and clean their room. So literally for 3 days, they're gonna have to clean their own room.
And what are you gonna be doing during that meantime?
A lot of things. You know, paperwork. It's a lot of paperwork involved. I have to be supervising, obviously, making sure, you know, everybody has what they need. No one's violating protocol, because if somebody violates protocol, it can literally ruin the event. So, you know, it's a lot of pressure, not just on the fighters and coaches, just on everybody involved. It's definitely something that everybody needs to play their part.
So the fighters are going to be locked in the room. Will they be able to go to like a small gym, have a particular time where they can go, you know, run out some extra, you know, that water weight before weigh-in time on Friday?
Yes. So, I mean, that's part of the protocol as well. If they want to use the gym there at the hotel, they got to let me know, and then I will block a certain time when they can go. So normally, depending on how many people need to use it, they'll get up to an hour. If, you know, if there's not that many people that need the gym, they might get 2 hours just by themselves in the gym trying to lose that weight.
Makes sense. It's a lot of stuff that people probably didn't even know about until now, right?
Mm-mm.
Now, let's talk about the day of the event, which is going to be Friday. Weigh-ins are Thursday. It's not open to the public. Friday, the event takes place, Southern Junction. This is like, I guess, the third, if I'm not mistaken, the third, fourth event, give or take.
Fourth or fifth event,
yeah. Yeah, it's right around there. Now, the day of the event, what is the capacity level? Because there are a lot of people that are still concerned, you know, about the capacity.
I mean, definitely concerning. I mean, Texas rules here in the state of Texas, it's at 50%. So we have 50% capacity. That place is occupied 2,000, so we sold a little under 1,000 tickets. You know, I think we printed out probably like 900, so a little bit less than 50%. Just to be safe, obviously, you know, everybody's required to wear the mask when they come in. They're going to get tested. Well, they're going to get their temperature tested. They're going to fill out a small waiver, make sure they're not sick or have any kind of symptoms before they're even allowed to come inside the place. So, you know, if you are buying tickets and you are going to the fight, just know there might be a little line outside. But like I said, it's for the safety of everybody.
What time does the event start?
Doors open at 7, and we're projecting the first fight at 8 o'clock.
8 o'clock, okay. And you suggest everybody to be there promptly before time just so they can make sure they can grab a good seat, because it is general admission.
It's general admission, first come, first serve. So all the seats are the same. If you get there early, you get the front row, and if you get there late, you get the last row. And if you get there really late and there's no more seats, you might be standing up. I mean, unfortunately, that's the way it goes. We did it that way because, again, you know, we're spacing out the seats in a certain way as well to protect everybody from themselves. So we didn't want nobody to get upset if they bought a very expensive ticket and then they're at a weird angle. So we just made it, hey, you know what?
It's all local fighters, right? This time it's all local fighters because the previous one was all, was majority, some fighters from California, some fighters around the area of Texas, all
Arizona,
around the area.
Florida, yeah.
So
yeah,
now it's all fighters. So tell me a little bit more about the card.
Yeah, so the card, luckily, you know, due to the whole COVID restrictions and, you know, rules, it's very strict, and it's going to be very crazy to get somebody from out of town to come fight. You know what it costs, and just for their safety that's involved with travel and plane, it's too much. So we decided, hey, you know what, let's make this a local card. Literally throughout the whole DFW, we got people from Fort Worth, Denton, Grand Prairie, Irving, Dallas. They're all going to be fighting. So this is an amazing opportunity for these local talent guys to show what they've been working on. You know, people are going to be there watching, and it's definitely a great opportunity for them.
How many fights are there again?
Six.
Six fights. And who's the co-main event and who's the main event?
Co-main event is going to be Mark Vazquez. Obviously, he trains here at Sweat.
One of your fighters.
One of my fighters. He's looking really good, really strong. Should be a good fight. And then obviously the main event is, you know, Rafael Listo Gaitan. You know, also he trains here. You know, he's been working out hard. He's been out for like 6 months. You know, first, you know, due to the back issue, and the second one due to COVID. So now he's itching to get back. Should be another exciting fight. And just overall, the whole card is gonna be good. We got Ben from Fort Worth, Ramiro from Fort Worth, and then we also got Shamaria. You know, a young kid that's 6'6", 160 pounds. So you can only imagine he probably should be playing basketball. But yeah, you know, it should be definitely a great card. And we got Dominique from Irving Powell. So it's definitely
a lot of local fighters.
All local fighters, absolutely.
Now, where can people reach you if they want tickets?
Okay, so if they have a favorite fighter, you can get your tickets directly from them, obviously. Which helps them and benefits them because they obviously get 10% of their ticket sales. So if you have a favorite fighter, you know, contact them through Facebook, Instagram, whatever. They're ready to sell. Obviously, if you can't get a hold of them and you still want to go to the show, you can reach us also at Sweat Boxing and Training. You can reach me directly on my Facebook or Instagram, and my phone number is 972-800-2882.
After the fights are over, I'll speak with you to tell me how it went, because I know there's a lot that you're going to have to tell me that went in the back works. So I'm excited for this. I'm excited for you. Obviously, I tell you all the time, I know we play around a lot, but I'm excited for you that this is continuous for you, and hopefully, which it will be, that will lead on to bigger and better things, right?
Yeah, hopefully. You know, like I said, if this goes well, we already have projected the next one beginning early of next year, but that's all I can say.
Yeah. Hector Vazquez, owner of Sweat Boxing Gym here in Irving, Texas, and as well the event coordinator or planner for Mikey Garcia Promotions. Thank you, Hector.
Thank you.